In the previous video, we have learned that by getting the gradient of a displacement time graph, we are able to know or we are able to determine the value of the velocity in the velocity time graph. Now, are we able to do something the other way around? Means by are we able to determine, let's say, something from a velocity time graph in order to relate it to the displacement time graph? Well, you can, okay? We get from displacement time graph to velocity time graph using the gradient of displacement time graph. But in order to get from velocity time graph to the displacement, we actually need something called the area under the graph. Okay, so if you look over at this equation over here, this equation just now, we used in the previous video to tell us that the gradient of the ST graph will be equals to the value in the VT graph. Okay, gradient is equals to the value. Now let's do a bit of rearrangement to this equation over here, making it something like this. Okay, so previously the dt was down here. What we do is we shift it to the left hand side. And now dt is over here. Well, now vx times dt is equals to dx. Vx is something on the y-axis in the vt graph. Dt is something on the x-axis of the vt graph. So if you take something on the y-axis, multiply something on the x-axis, it's similar to finding an area, right? Because area is length times width. You take something on the vertical side, multiply something on the horizontal side. By getting the area, you are able to get, by multiplying these two things together, you are able to get area, right? So this left-hand side over here, it is representing the area under the VT graph actually. So this is area under the VT graph within the little infinitesimal time dt. Okay, but we are going to extend this this equivalence here to a bigger time interval. Okay, this is just to let you know the idea. Okay, so area under the graph here is equivalent to d is an infinitesimal change, right? So here is a change of position during time dt. So means by what? If we are able to get the area under the VT graph, then the area here will be representing the amount of change in position that happens during that time interval. Let's say if I'm able to get the area under the graph from time equals to 0 to time equals to 2, I'm able to find the area under this line over here. Then the area that I found will be equivalent to the change of position that happens during from time equals to 0 to time equals to 2. So these two things can be equivalent to each other. Okay, let's get right into the example so that we can know this thing more concretely. So the first example is, let's say I determine the area under the graph from time equals to 0 to time equals to 2. So you take 2, multiply by 3 becomes 6, divide by half because it's a triangle, then you get 3. So you know the area over here is 3 meter. How do you know the unit here is meter? Well, you take something with a unit of meter per second, multiply with something with a unit of second, right? Meter per second times second, you get meter. Then divide by 2, you will still retain the same unit. So the answer here is meter. So from here, you know it will be related to something like displacement or position or distance, something like that, because the unit is in meter. The dimension of length. So by knowing that, you are able to deduce that this will be related to something about the position or displacement. And yes, it is true, it is related to the change of position. So change of position from t0 to t2 will be from here to here. So this is the amount of change that happened. Initially it was at here, then time equals to 2, then it enters this, it moved from the initial position to this value x equals to 3 over here. So if you measure this length over here, you get 3 meter, exactly the area under the graph that you determine over here. Okay, let's do a few more examples and I believe you slowly get the idea. Let's move on to this part. Let's say you find the area under the graph from t equals to 2 to t equals to 6. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 seconds multiplied by 3 meter per second. So you get 12 meter. So 12 meter here tells you that the change of position during time equals to 2 to time equals to 6. So the change of position is from here to here. So this change of position here will be equivalent to the area under the graph that you determine here. So you know that the area here will be 12 meter. 12 meter is not from the initial position here. It's from the initial position at time equals to 2 to the final position at time equals to 6. So this amount of distance here is 12 meter. Okay, let's continue to the next section. From time equals to 6 to time equals to 8, you determine this triangle, the area of this triangle here, you get 2 seconds times 3 meter per second, 6 meter per second, divide by 2 because it's a triangle, so you get 3 meter. So 3 meter will be representing the amount of displacement from this initial position to that final position. So if you measured it, yes, it is indeed 3 meter. Okay, so you don't need to do it section by section. Let's say today I straight away get the whole area over here using the area of a trapezium. Okay, 1 over 2 bracket A plus B multiplied by H. If you use the formula to determine the area of this trapezium here, I believe you get 18 meter. But since this area is below the time axis, any area that is below the x-axis, in this case the time axis, we'll call it a negative area. So this will be negative 18 meter. So if it's negative 18 meter, it tells you that the displacement is 18 meter, but since that's negative, the displacement is in the negative direction. So it means by you are moving towards the left. Okay, so technically you make a U-turn, then you move in the opposite direction towards the left. Before that, everything here is positive, right? So positive means by you are moving in the positive x direction. But now since it's negative, you are moving in the negative x direction. For how much? For 80 meters. So that's why if you measure from this specific time equals to 8 to time equals to 16, you measure the amount of distance traveled within that time, you see that it's negative 80 meter. Okay, the distance traveled is 18, then the direction is negative, therefore in the negative x direction. Okay, so the area under the graph here will be representing the change of position that happens within that time interval. That's how you relate from the velocity time graph to the displacement time graph. So there are two things that you are usually asked to determine when you have a velocity time graph. Let's say today using this velocity time graph here, let's say the question asks you, what is the total distance traveled? Well, are you able to determine it? Yeah, determine it without using the ST graph? Yes, you can actually, because you know that this area here, this area under the graphs here, are representing the displacement at different period of time, right? So if you want to find the distance travel, total distance travel, you just add on all the length of the path that has been traveled. So you add up 3, add up 12, add up 3, add up 18, right? Without caring about the sign. Because no matter what direction you move to the left, move to the right, you don't care about direction, you care how much distance travel. So the negative here, don't need to care about it. So you can just do your 3 plus 12 plus 3 plus 18, then you get your answer 36. Can you do this without the displacement time graph? Yes. So what you can do is just find the area under the graph for the whole time period from time equals to 0 to time equals to 16. Find the total area without caring whether it's above or below the negative, below the x-axis, just add them all up together, then you get your total distance travel. But if they ask for the displacement, say this ask, what is the displacement of this person from time equals to 0 to time equals to 16? Okay, from the 0 second to the 16 second, what is the displacement that occurred? So when you talk about displacement, you have to care about the direction, right? So here he is moving 80 meters towards the positive x direction, then move another 80 meters, but in the opposite direction. So at the end, it arrives back on the time axis, right? So if you drag it back, that means it arrives back at the initial position. So in that case, you should expect your answer to be 3 plus 12 plus 3. Minus 18, because now the 18 here is in the opposite direction. So you should expect something like this, and the answer should be 0. Because initially at time equals 0, it's standing here. But when time is equal to 16, it is back at its initial position. So final and initial are at the same position, you should get the displacement of 0. Are you able to determine this using the velocity time graph without having the displacement time graph? Yes. So how do you do it? You get all the area above the time axis, which are representing the amount of distance traveled in the positive x direction, minus the area under the graph below the time axis. The area under the graph below the time axis represents motion or distance traveled in the negative x direction. So if you take the distance traveled in the positive x direction minus the distance traveled in the negative x direction, you will get the resultant displacement or the final displacement. So this is what has been traveled in the positive x direction. This is what has been traveled in the negative x direction. So if you calculate them, caring about whether it's above or below the time axis, if it's below, you put negative, then you end up with the correct answer, which is 0 meter. So total distance traveled and displacement are questions that are often being asked. So you know that how should you get information regarding ST graph from the velocity time graph by using the idea of area under the graph. So by talking about the relationship between velocity time graph and displacement time graph, we can make such a conclusion over here. In order to relate displacement time graph to velocity, we can determine the gradient of the displacement time graph, and it will tell us information about the velocity. But if you want to get from velocity time graph to displacement time graph, by finding the area under the graph for a certain time interval, then you are able to determine the change of position or the displacement within that time interval. So this is how it relates between displacement time graph and velocity time graph.